Hi, I'm Annie. Today I want to talk about the power of objectifying yourself. I've noticed over and over again in my life, anytime growth has occurred, it is because I've in some way stepped outside of myself and observed myself more rationally. Seeing myself objectively and separating myself from whatever is triggering me. Whatever the freak out is, I step outside of it and observe myself, observe my tendencies, and then understand that from that vantage point of the observer, that I have choices. I can decide to perceive the situation differently, or switch to a more solution kind of mindset instead of getting freaked out. I've noticed that this ability to observe myself is the common denominator in every situation where I've grown, where I've been able to change my habits and patterns and change my perception. So I'm always looking for different ways to do that and incorporate more of that into my life and find ways to observe myself, you know, in other areas. I came across something on Facebook the other day that I thought was really brilliant. It was someone describing a process where they were having an anxiety attack. And in that moment, they felt inspired to turn on their camera and just do the anxiety attack in front of the camera. So that way they could watch it back later and sort of observe what was going on a little bit more rationally. I've never actually had an anxiety attack, but I do appreciate that it can be very extreme. I don't want to in any way invalidate the potential severity of something like that, because from what I understand about anxiety attacks, it might not always be reasonable to have enough rationality to stop what you're doing and turn on a camera. In this case, the person was feeling a little panicky and they had the wherewithal and you know, enough control and presence to stop and turn on the camera. And they found this exercise really helpful. And I think that's a really creative solution. I really like that idea. For myself, in my own anxiety, I'm pretty good at observing it objectively. Anytime I have an anxious thought, that's kind of a trigger for me to stop what I'm doing, step outside of myself and observe it. Sometimes I negotiate with the fear rationally, or sometimes I just work with it on a somatic level. If I'm feeling anxious, there's a chemical signature within my body, chemicals of anxiety. So what can I do on a somatic level to feel safer? And I might do, you know, an exercise like vagus nerve exercise, visualization, meditation, something calming that is actually going to change the chemicals inside my body to make me feel safer and more grounded. I'm pretty good at doing that. Where I still get really, really fucked up is with technological difficulties, computer issues, printer issues, and I just freak the fuck out. It's just, I become irrational. So for me, that would be a good moment to maybe stop if I'm feeling that freak out, turn on the camera, talk it through. And then I could view that footage back and sort of look at myself more rationally. It would help me to double observe. So what I would like to do is eventually get to a place where this is no longer an issue, where these freak outs don't take me down. Like usually several times a week, I get so frustrated. And I think the feeling behind it is that I have showed up to do my work for the day. I want to be efficient. I'm here with my best attitude, but I can't even print this page. Like I can't even get past this like super trivial barrier. And it's maybe like 20 or 30 minutes lost on once again reinstalling the printer driver. And I just have showed up to be efficient and successful in my day, but I just can't get past this trivial thing. And it just makes me irate. It's wonderful that my partner is a double observer. Sometimes on a good day, I have enough presence of mind to stop in that moment and go ask him for help. But ultimately, I can't rely on him to bail me out of these situations. I need to be able to double observe myself, to stop and problem solve on my own without getting totally destabilized by frustration. And I really do feel like the moment of stopping and stepping outside of yourself and observing, that's like 80% of the battle. If you can get in the habit of doing that, of stopping and observing yourself, you're like almost there. Like you can absolutely solve whatever problem you're having if you can do that. If you can learn to do that when you're triggered. So I just thought that was a really creative solution or a creative way to use video for any kind of freak out situation. Just the remembering and the stopping and the pausing and observing is huge. That is an enormous first step. And this idea of turning on the camera and talking talking it through and then really watching yourself freak out, I think you could learn a lot from that. It just seems really powerful. Another thing that came up on Facebook in the last couple of weeks was just an interesting question. If you met a clone of yourself, would you like yourself? Would you get along? What my mind immediately goes to is efficiency, because, you know, I love efficiency. I have that TE in my stack. I would think like, wow, we could get so much done if there were two of me. My immediate thought was that I would love to just work quietly beside myself in my art studio and get twice as much done. But I also went to this thought of observing myself. If my clone was freaking out and I could be the observer, then I could play the opposite part and help. If my clone was single observing, then I could step into that double observer part and help. I think it's such an interesting thought experiment. Maybe it would make it even easier to observe self and learn and grow from being able to see self objectively. There's also this dynamic that whatever void one person is leaving, the other person will fill. So if there's a lead TE that's just all in on TE, then whoever, you know, the other person is in the relationship dynamic, they might bring the FI. Not necessarily because that's their dominant function, just because the other person is going to fill the void. So if you were the other half of a clone and one of you was triggered and freaked out and kind of spiraling on some sort of, you know, irrational path, the other one could be the sane one in that moment and help to find some rational solution in the situation. Now, I don't know how this would work. This is like parallel universe stuff. So it could be that if you're freaking out, then your clone is also freaking out. But I just think that's such an interesting thought experiment, and you could really get a lot of growth out of that, out of just, you know, playing out that scenario in your mind. Like, what would that be? What could you do with your clone? What would it bring out? What would it help you discover? If you just sort of imagine that scenario, I'm sure you could discover all kinds of things. So my mind went to, you know, a specific direction, double observing, observing self, and being efficient and getting more done. But, you know, someone else with a different type or a different background, different history might see some other really creative potential in that scenario. I'm just curious, if you could interact with your own clone, what do you think that dynamic would be like? Would it be a good thing? Would there be growth there, or would it be total chaos? Let me know what you think.